Procreate is one of the best apps that you can use to draw or sketch note on your iPad. It only costs $10, from which you'll get a lot of value. If you're new to it, no worries, this video is for you. Today I have my colleague Kate with us, who will guide us step by step into a beginner's tutorial for Procreate. You'll learn how to select and use brushes, writing, drawing icons, shading, using layers, colors, and all the most important functions. Procreate also offers the possibility to record what you're drawing, so that you can save a time-lapse video that you can use for your visual communication. Let's start. Hello, Kate.
Hello, Amico.
I'm so happy to have you here and show us what is Procreate and how we can best use it for graphic facilitation. My first question is, what is Procreate? Can you show us a little bit around?
As you can see, it's a drawing app. So this is how the app looks like. Procreate, you can find it in the App Store, available for 10 euros, and you have it for life once you've downloaded it and paid for it once. This is my portfolio, the things that I've drawn. I'm gonna show you how to start. So on the right hand top, you have screen size, new combine. And from here, you can pick your preferred size. I normally go for a screen size. I'm gonna show you different things that you can find. One of the things are the brushes. Of course, that's a good start to have. My favorite brushes are dry ink, the technical pen and the gel pen. It really differs for what you use it for and the feel and light that you like it to have. So one of my favorites, technical pen, I'm gonna use this one. So let's draw some simple things, such as like a line, and normally people will just go ahead and draw a line. And you can totally tell it's not straight. However, I'm gonna show you a quick trick to draw a perfectly straight line. You just hold it for a second and it will automatically snap into a perfectly straight line. The same goes for triangles, for circles, and squares, of course, or rectangulars. And if you want to erase, you can use your two fingers to tap back. And if you want to reverse back, you use three fingers and tap on your screen and it's back. You can also undo by clicking on the left bottom arrow. Another thing, which is really nice, is Canva, and then you go to drawing guide. So then you have grid lines to help you make a perfect straight line. If you go to edit drawing guides, you can even enable assisted drawing, meaning you'll only be able to draw within those lines. So I'm gonna show you, if I'm gonna draw a line like this, it will go straight because you're only able to draw straight lines. And you can also adjust it and make it into turned into isometric or perspective. This is also very nice if you want to draw a house, for example. I'm gonna undo them all. And if you want to undo quickly, you can just hold with two fingers and it's all gone. And I have a clean slate. So let's have a look at the colors. Of course, you can add your own colors as you please. So how do you do it? You can import it from gallery, or you can also play around and choose your colors, but you also have default palettes already here for you, which are really nice to use. I like to use dry ink when I'm gonna draw an ink. So I'm gonna draw a nice circle like this. And you can go ahead and ink it like this, or you can go for the shortcut and drag from the right top hand, drag the yellow and pop it into the circle. So you have a really nice circle. To give it a bit of a shadow, you go back to your color palette on the right hand, right top side, and I'm gonna move it slightly down so you have a slightly darker color, and you can create a shadow here. But of course, you can make mistakes and it looks kind of slubby, so there's a way to make sure it's inside of the circle. So I'm gonna use alpha lock, which basically locks everything, and you can only color inside of the circle like this. So for example, right now I want to, I'm going to increase my brush size to do this. And I'm going to create a really nice shadow for my circle. Now I want to go back to the same color here. So I'm going to just tap and you have the same color here back. I want to go for a lighter color for the top, like this. I'm going to slightly give it a pop at the top, imagining the sun is on the left top. Then I want to increase the shadows. And here you can see the difference between the lighter color and the color that we're picking right now. So this is a really easy way to color and make something look three-dimensional.
Can you show us the difference between the different brushes you love and maybe also telling us when you use one versus the other?
When I'm drawing and I'm also inking with the same pen, I really like to draw and use dry ink. The technical pen is really nice for precise drawings or writing. So this is the technical pen.
I see now that we have little space. Can we resize the sun so we can also make some space for writing?
Yes, of course. In here you see different layers. We'll go into details a bit later. You make sure you select the layer that you want to resize. From there you make sure to select it. And then from there you click on the pointer and you can basically uniform it. You can make it smaller, bigger, I can flip it. And flip it the other way around, however you like it. Distort it, can you even turn it into more of an egg. And if I want to reverse it, I'm gonna double tap again. So let's say we don't need our sun anymore, and here. But you can also unselect it and it's gone from there.
Now you just made a new layer, the layer with the sun. So it's still there, it's just we're not visualizing.
Yeah, I did not select it exactly. It's the layer is still here. I'm just gonna use a new layer and I don't want to see this one anymore. And I'm gonna use it here. You can use layers really nicely, for example, if you want to draw something else on top of it, but you're unsure if it looks nice, or for example, I want to turn it into smiley, but then I'm like, okay, that's not so nice. But then it's merged into the layer, but now I can just unselect it as I want. So most of the times I really recommend using layers. You can easily remove and add on things, which is really nice, and it's a really nice feature from Procreate.
Okay, let's now try to write something and put it in a container.
So now I've chosen the technical pen. Here you can adjust your brush size. Here we go, I'm gonna say hello. To draw perfectly straight lines, I'm going to use the drawing guide. So I'm clicking on the drawing guide and I make sure the assisted drawing is on. And now I don't need it anymore. I'm going back to edit drawing, untoggle the drawing. As I just taught you, I want to color my rectangular, so I'm going to drag the ball from right hand side up here. Then I want to make sure that I have nice shadows, so I'm going to alpha lock this, select a slightly darker color here, and I'm going to use another brush and dry ink. Now you see my hello has disappeared because we've created another layer on top of it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna make sure this is on top of the other layer and we have a really nice rectangular with a welcome message in it.
Should we try to draw an icon and see how easy is that to make it nice with Procreate?
So I'm gonna draw a light bulb, really easy. Maybe it'll start with black and then we can color it in. So I'm gonna draw a circle. From here, so that we're drawing a U underneath it, then the M and the Z. So it looks really nice. Then from here, I want to color it, so I want to make it yellow. And we drag it inside, and we have a really nice light bulb.
So, how do we save our artwork?
So it's automatically saved. So if you go back to gallery, You'll see it in the left-hand corner that is already there. Click it and you're back. So a nice way to share your drawing with others or even post it on social media is to click on share, then share it as PDF, JPEG or PNG. Depends on how you want to use it. And most of the times I use JPEG or PNG to upload it into my social media or even use it in my PowerPoint slides. And another cool feature is to use it as a video. Every single time you draw, it's recording your time-lapse. Make sure to have it on. Then you click on time-lapse replay and you can basically follow every single step that you've taken, drawn, and done on your Canva, which is really cool.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for your time. If you have any question, please write them down here in the chat. And if you have any additional topic you'd like us to cover, just let us know. Thanks for watching.
Thank you. And make sure to subscribe.
See you in my next digital tip.